portfolio management. So far, we've been looking at the challenge of innovation selection, and particularly at the question of how we judge whether or not to proceed with an innovation project. That's particularly the challenge in a startup, but of course, as the organization gets larger, so the challenge becomes not only how to assess a single project, but how to assess multiple competing projects. And within that, the real question is how we get a balance, how we balance the risk and reward, some high risk, not many of them, a lot of them low risk, but also low reward. How we balance things like exploiting versus exploring, building on what we know against learning something new. How we stretch our horizons in time and space, and so on. In other words, how do we build a balanced portfolio of innovation projects? Now, it's important that we take this thing seriously, because if we don't have some kind of portfolio management, a number of problems can emerge. For example, if we don't have any judgment, there are no limits to the projects we're going to take on, and as a result, we'll spread our resources too thinly. If we don't make a judgment and get the balance right, we're going to find ourselves in all sorts of difficulty. Particularly, some projects will consume huge amounts of time and resource, and the result will be that the cost, the budget, and the time overruns. If we haven't really got a portfolio approach, then we'll take on everything, and we may find ourselves starving other projects of resources because we're afraid to kill off projects we probably shouldn't have started in the first place. If we don't have a strategic approach to portfolio management, then we could find that unimportant projects get support, which is an opportunity cost for some of the other more important projects. And if the criteria we use in judging and building our portfolio are not very good, then we might find we're supporting projects which don't really have a strong supportive case, or maybe some senior manager is able to pick a favourite project even though it doesn't actually stand up in the portfolio. And the risk is we run too many average projects with little impact, and that doesn't help in trying to grow the business. So we need to think hard about strategic portfolio management. And what we really need here, just as in the case of search, is strategic frameworks. Particularly when we're working with incremental, do what we do better innovation, that's a very different set of questions around selection to when we're dealing with high uncertainty associated with radical innovation. The good news is that we can use frameworks like the 4Ps innovation compass, like the three horizons in time and space that we've already seen when we considered the search question. And incremental innovation decisions are very much based on using existing knowledge about exploitation, and so the question really is how well do these fairly safe bets fit with our overall strategic direction? When we're talking about more radical innovation, do different, then the decisions involve high uncertainty, and we really need to have a story, a narrative, a business model which explains how and why doing this is going to take us forward. But the key is to build a mixed and a balanced portfolio. Quite a lot of safe bets, a few higher risk but potentially higher reward projects. So, how can we do it? Well, it's important to think in terms of strategy, regularly reviewing the projects that we have underway and previewing the future portfolio. And particularly this question of balancing, exploiting and exploring needs to be at the centre. There are several simple approaches. For example, checklists, scoring systems, essentially comparing different project options side by side and choosing the most favourable. In the case of incremental innovation, one of the powerful tools is something called policy or strategy deployment. Essentially, how well do these incremental innovations support our overall strategic journey? They're sometimes called how-why charts. For example, in this small picture, the overall strategic objective is we want to reduce quality problems. We get a lot of customer complaints. We want to cut those problems by 20%. How are we going to do it? Well, there are many potential innovation projects, but what we can do just to make sure that they fit is to ask the simple question, why? If we go upwards as we look at those projects, we should arrive at something which helps us with that overall strategic objective. If we go downwards, we can generate a series of projects, but they're not random innovation projects, they're aligned. This idea of policy or strategy deployment. Particularly when organizations are mobilizing a lot of suggestions from a workforce, perhaps on a collaboration platform, these sorts of tools built around innovation campaigns can be very powerful. There's also a series of visual tools, what are often called matrix methods, which allow us to explore and see an innovation portfolio in visual terms. A useful variation on this is something called a bubble chart. And this is essentially a matrix approach, but adding in the size of the project, some indication of time or cost or commitment. And we could use different axes as before, for example, risk and reward or market share and market growth. But the key point with a bubble chart is that the bigger the bubble on the chart, the bigger the bet. And so we can see whether we're placing a small bet, which might be high risk, but it's only a small thing, or whether we're concentrating our resources too heavily in one or two rather big bets. Here's an example of a simple bubble chart. It's measuring on the matrix the probability of success, some measure of risk, against the expected value, some measure of reward. And you can see we can compare these different projects. We probably shouldn't be doing number one, because it's essentially low probability of success, and even if we did succeed, it's not going to bring us much. Equally, a high probability of success and a high probability in terms of expected value, the pearls in that top right-hand corner, would be good to place big bets there. So bubble charts can be quite powerful ways of helping us with our selection decision. But again, the challenge is trying to build a balanced portfolio. So let's summarize where we've been in this short film. For anything but a startup, we're concerned not only with evaluating and selecting a single project, but about multiple competing projects. We need to ensure a balance between risk, we exploit and explore different horizons and so on. We need some way of reviewing our portfolio, and visual approaches can help, particularly things like matrix and bubble charts. But really radical projects challenge our immune system. So we need different ways of looking at that.